And God stepped out on space. And he looked around and said, I'm lonely. I'll make me a world. And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything. Blacker than 100 nights down in a cypress swamp. Then God smiled and the light broke. The darkness rolled up on one side and the light stood shining on another. And God said, that's good. Then God reached out and took the light in his hands. And God rolled the light in his hands until he made the sun. And he set the sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left making the sun, he gathered up in a shining ball and flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with the moon and the stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world. And God said, that's good. Then God himself stepped down, the sun on his right hand, the moon on his left. The stars were clustered above his head. The earth was under his feet. And God walked. And where he trod, his footsteps hollowed out the valleys and bulged up the mountains. Then he stopped. He looked and saw that the earth was hot and barren. God stepped over to the edge of the world, and he spat out the seven seas. He batted his eyes, and the lightning flashed. He clapped his hands, and the thunders rolled. The waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down. Then the grass, green, sprouted up, and the little red flowers blossomed. The pine tree pointed its finger to the sky. The oak spread out his arms. The lakes cuddled down in the hollows of the ground, and the rivers ran down to the sea. And again, God smiled, and the rainbow appeared and curled itself around his shoulders. Then God raised his arm and waved his hand over the sea and over the land. He said, bring forth, bring forth. And quicker than God could drop his hand, fishes and fowls, beasts and birds, swim the seas and the rivers, run the forests and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, that's good. Then God walked around, and God looked around. He looked at the sun, he looked at his moon, he looked at his little stars, he looked on his world with all his living things, and he said, I'm still lonely. Then God sat down on a hill where he could think. Deep by the river, he sat down with his head in his hands, and he thought, till he thought, I'll make man. Up from the bed of the river, God scooped up the clay. By the bank of the river, he kneeled him down. There, the great God Almighty, who lit the sun and fixed the sky, who flung the stars most far in the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand. This great God, like Mary bending over her baby, kneeled down from the dust, toiling over the clay, till he shaped in his own image, until he blew the breath of life, and man became a living soul.